Hello everyone, my name is Anubhav and I have been software engineer for 9 years now. I have worked on multiple projects and companies since 2014 and observed the things that are crucial to be a better dev. In this video, I am going to focus on the skills for a senior software engineer and how they help in day-to-day activities for them. You can disagree or agree, but they are purely my experience. You can comment down if you disagree. So let's quickly get started. So the first thing which is extremely important for a senior engineer is that you should be able to understand what you are implementing. Now it might sound simple, but many times people miss the point that, for example, if you are using a database, then you should know a little more than just a breadth about the database. If you are using Kafka, then you should know a little more than just covering a few commands of Kafka. If you are using Elasticsearch, then you should know a little more than a few commands of Elasticsearch. Why that is important? It is important because everything will be fine till the time everything is fine. But the day that things go wrong, you are the one who would be expected to fix it. You are the one to whom people will look up to and seek solutions. So if you don't understand the things which you implement, it will be very hard for you. So it's important to understand a little more than covering a breadth. Have more depth as well as breadth when you implement or use anything in your project. Because at the end of the day, more senior you become in your company, your design choices and the design choices which you collaborate and implement, of course, it might not be dependent upon just one person bias, but overall, you'll have more impact on the design choices. So a wrong design choice could lead to a fatal death of a project for the next 2 or 3 years. So it's important to understand more, understand that what are the good database choices, what are the good networking protocol choices, what actually happens at the system level. So you need to know a little more than building a few APIs, calling some databases, writing some code. A little more maturity, a little more sense on what things are. It might sound simple, but many times if people miss it, then it just gets hard for them. The second important thing, and this is something which is rarely talked about by us engineers, is skill of good comprehension. Now, this might sound like a English or a language lecture, but it is extremely important because you deal with a lot of text data. You go and read about Elasticsearch, you need to go through their documentation. If you talk about Java, you have to go through a documentation. Yes, a lot of common things are already done by the community and many good people have posted a lot of great videos online and you can just go through them. But there are many places where majority of the times you will have the textual data. You have to read a big documentation, extract the information quickly and then implement those things. And you also might have to write a good documentation or a good text. So the reading of text, even in your company, people write wikis or you write a doc, you read somebody else's doc, you review the documentations, etc. So a lot of reading is required. So what happens is that people who have lost the ability or they are not very comfortable in reading long text because they have somehow been spoiled with the video related content already available, it just gets hard for them because as and when you grow the content online on or the video based content online will be lesser and lesser because let's be honest, the content online on videos, etc., they are available for the majority of the people, which solves the problem for the majority of the people. But what if something is required which is just out of the box? You might have to read a lot compared to viewing and listening to the things. So that just gets important. The The third thing is also extremely important is the ability to communicate better. Again, this might sound simple, but it gets extremely important. It is not related just to software engineering, but everywhere else as well. But here it just gets more and more important, right from what it used to be when you started your career compared to what it becomes later down the line for your career. So for example, what happens is that you initially, when you would have started your career, you generally interact with a few people of your team, or maybe one or two people cross team. But the moment you grow more, you need to communicate more with the people, cross geolocations, cross teams, and different types of people. For example, they might be customers, they might be support engineers, they might be product managers, engineering managers, senior managers, lead, SD1s, tools, etc. And it gets extremely important for you to tweak or give the right information, to change the information in a way which the listener or the person to whom you are talking to can understand. So the lines which you give to the customers or the support engineers can be a little different compared to what you give to a SD, because you can be more detailed when you talk to somebody in your team compared to when you talk to somebody outside of your team. So you can't just spill over the same information to everyone. And although looks very simple, but it just gets very important. And if you see things, the way we communicate has been changing a lot. So if you talk about pre-COVID time versus COVID time and versus the post-COVID time, where we are mostly in the hybrid world, the things have changed a bit. Now it's more about the camera, looking into the camera, or most of the time people don't even turn on the camera. So you have to rely mostly on the voice, and you need to gauge the signals using the voices. You don't have a visual signal of what people are, people nodding or are people just getting bored, etc. So it just gets a little harder. You have to judge things with the voice. But overall, the communication aspects hold true for a video-based call, audio-based call, or a written text, documentation, as I already talked about, a lot of other things. So it just gets important about the documentation. And just to add one more thing with the documentation is to have a good skill on ability to give and take feedbacks. So let's say out of a goodwill, you wish to give a feedback to someone. Now, if you directly approach to that person and say that, hey, I just find your presentations boring, or you are not good at all. So these are the plain statements which do not help anyone. You need to be very specific on the things which you need for them to improve. And there are various techniques to do that. You can start with, hey, I really liked your presentation. I liked the way you got into the depth. However, if you could improve a bit on the interactive part, so the way you communicate the feedback, it's extremely important so that they would feel positive enough to inculcate them. The moment you come up and say to someone that, hey, you are a boring presenter, it's not going to help anyone. They would get defensive and they might question you or your intent that, hey, why do you think the presentation was boring? It might be boring because you were not interested enough. But the moment you come up and say that, hey, there was a detailed presentation, I really like the amount of depth you got into, and then you add a bunch of good things which there were in the particular presentation, and then you can add that, hey, apart from all these good things, if you add a little bit of audience interaction, maybe, so that the audience is mostly interested in your content, that will be a great hit. So that point will really help. So there are multiple skills or the multiple ways in which you can give and take feedbacks. So it's important to have these difficult conversations as well. Happy conversations are mostly easy, but the conversations like these and being good at these also just gets important. I'm specifically talking about this particular point for a software engineering, because it is not at all important when you are at the beginning of career in software engineering, because you deal with very less people, maybe 4 or 5 people of your team and cross team, but it just gets important later down the career. It might not be the case for others. For example, if somebody is in a public facing profession, say doctor or anyone else, it is just important from day one. But here, it just gets important over time. The other thing is that I think this is also very important. I think all the points are important, whatever I'm talking about, is that you still need to be a friend with the code. So it is unacceptable for an engineer to come up and say that, hey, I used to code long back and now I mainly lead people. That's not how things work. You need to be worth your salt if you understand the coding well. So it's just important, because many times you will have to write code if needed. You will have to review the code. And there are a lot of low-level details which are there in a particular project. So somebody can come up that, hey, the particular piece of code, it's just hard to implement because of so-and-so constraint. You would not be able to understand the challenges if you do not understand the low-level details. So always be in touch with what is happening in your project. Always try to gauge things so that you can help people. At the abstract level, it's very easy to say that, hey, can you optimize the code? Can you write a readable code, etc.? You can just, you know, throw up all the jargons and all the hi-fi words which we generally are used to listen to, but that will not help anyone. You should be able to read the code fast. You should be able to give feedbacks and understand the code fast, because you have had the experience of many years and people look up to you for the solutions. So having understanding of the code will never go away. It will also be important. Let's say you are stuck in a problem statement. Let's say you have a zookeeper in your company and it just started to act up in a way which nobody understands. Nobody can find it online. You might even have to clone the code because they are open source. You might have to look a particular piece of code. First of all, figure out where the particular piece of code lies and then understand it and then maybe make some sense out of it. So at times you might have to do that. Many people do that. I can't talk about the zookeeper example, but there are other examples where this happens, that you clone somebody else's repo and then you understand what's going on. So it just happens more often than we think of. So that's also important skills overall. The last thing is around the work and how to be smart around doing your work. So you should not reinvent the wheel. First of all, the thing is that you should figure out how can you reuse somebody else's work and how others can reuse your work. So let's say you are working on a project and you build something. If you build something in a way which others could use, that's a great thing. But if you do not even have to build something because somebody else has already built, that's even a smarter thing. Because what happens is that if you have lesser line of code, any day you will be maintaining the lesser work. I'm not correlating the lines of code to the amount of work you do, but if you reinvent the wheel, then you have to go through a lot of things like writing code, code reviews, deployments, pipelines, and then, you know, maintaining the servers, etc. So if you could find out a way in which you could reuse somebody else's work, or somebody else can use your work, it will be an awesome thing. So it will happen over time. Let's say if you are working and you are good in your skills, then you can figure out the open source solution. You can figure out what is there out in the world. Or if you have been working in a particular company, then you would know that what other team is doing. So can I reuse their work? Can I reuse somebody else's work, etc.? So it just gets easy if you cover more and more breadth. It just happens over time, but very important skill as well. So yeah, I think these 5-7 points which I talked about, they have been crucial for me. There are things which you could improve yourself, but these 5-7 points are very important. Try to inculcate them. Never forget about coding. It's just important at every level, at least till the level which I have been into. Try to cover more and more breadth of the technical skills. They will never go waste, and they will come in handy when things go wrong, when things are not available online on simple internet search. So in those cases, it will just be important having a good communication. Try to give and take feedback. Try to tweak the conversation in a way which will differ based on the audience would be important. And yeah, I think that's it from my side for this video. I hope you like this video. I post technical videos every week. I have been posting those videos on different topics like system design, gRPC. I have a complete playlist on gRPC on around 7 or 8 videos. I have a playlist on Apache Zookeeper of about 7 or 8 videos. I have various discussions and videos on various design choices like Kafka versus Redis for a particular scenario, or how do you build a chat application. Mostly I talk about the low level details. I don't talk about creating those boxes and then connecting them with the arrows. You could do that, of course, but I generally talk about the low level details so that if you are able to zoom into a problem statement and you are able to understand what's going on at the low level, you could extrapolate it to a bigger level. So I have covered lots of such videos in my various series. For example, why Cassandra and why not Cassandra. So you should check out those videos in my channel. They should definitely help you in one or the other ways. So yeah, that's it from my side for this video. Till the next time, bye.